Let me ask you one last question, unless Disco has one. Let's say WWE were to call you tomorrow and they were to say, hey, we want you to come back. Number one, how long would it take you to get into that type of shape? Would you want to do it? And how long do you think you could actually last on their schedule? 2 years, 3 years? Or would you go in there and say, hey, the only way I'm coming back is if you give me a reduced schedule?
No, I don't even, I haven't even entertained that, to be honest with you, yet, because it might just getting healthy. But I keep in peak shape constantly. I do burpees. Like, I, the other day, did 120 burpees after my workout and some other conditioning tools. Like, I stay, burpees are the one thing. Like, I'm always in shape. Like, any independent match I go and do, that burpees taught me a long time ago. Like, that will keep you in shape. You can do 100 burpees in under 10 minutes. You can go out and work any kind of match. So I'm always in shape. To me, it's a matter of, I wouldn't put myself in that position right now until I know that I'm ready to be able to perform at the level I want to perform day in and day out. And again, that full-time schedule, man, I look back, we're not meant to do that.
It's ridiculous.
I understand it's a business, but when you're using human bodies to make your money, and one guy's a billionaire, and the majority of people don't have any money that do this when they're done, it's lopsided on a lot of ways. And I like sleeping in my own bed. I like being with my dogs every night, and I love just waking up and being home and not sleeping in those fucking hotel rooms. It's like you're in prison, and people who don't understand that because they think you're traveling and seeing the world, but you're seeing the same airports, the same arenas, the same gyms,
right,
the same goddamn rental cars day in and day out. And it's like literally like Groundhog's Day, just day in and day out doing the same thing. Every city's the same. So to step out of that and to be able to enjoy life at a young age and see and be grateful that I have what I have, but to enjoy this, I'm not in no rush yet necessarily to want to even entertain that. Now, if I was 100%, you know, I have a lot to prove still. And I have a lot for myself that I haven't accomplished yet in the professional wrestling world. So from that, you know, inner competitive mindset that I have, you know, I would absolutely love to be able to do that one day for my fans and for myself, because the way that I left, I'm not happy about the way that I left. It was an absolute necessary, and I don't regret anything, but ideally I would have liked to have left under better circumstances, and I wouldn't have changed a thing, because that was how I felt at that period in time, and the way things were going, and with the contract negotiations, and I left a lot of money on the table. And it was not an easy decision by any means. But, you know, I've said after these two stem cell procedures in 2019 is when I think I'll end up being back on TV eventually. Whether that's for WWE or Impact or Ring of Honor, I don't know, or New Japan Pro Wrestling, because I haven't even entertained it anything with that the last 2 years. I've enjoyed the WWE, the independent schedule. And again, that window, as you know, only lasts for so long.